Already in the previous classes, we have discussed the three phyla, Coryphora, Tenaria and Tenopod. In this class, we are going to discuss about the phyla Platyhelminthes. So, Platyhelminthes is called Chappate Hulagalu. So they have got this name because of these two words. Flatty means flat. Flatty means flat. Helminthes means worms. Helminthes means worms. Means they are flattened organisms. Their body is compressed or flattened. Dorsal and ventral sides are compressed just like a leaf or a tail. Hence, they have got the name Platyhelminthes. Andre kannadalli helbekandre melbhaga mattu kelabhaga ondakkondu teera antukondu chappadi agide. Adukoskara avugalige chappadi hulugalu antanu karitivi. So next we will discuss about some of the general characters of this phyla. The first character. So these organisms are commonly called flatworms, you know very well, and these are bilaterally symmetrical. They are bilaterally symmetrical triploblastic organ level of organization and a coelomatic animus So here we are observing certain words which are new for us. Means we have discussed while we discuss in the basis of classification, but we have not seen these words in our previous groups of animals. In Coryphora, in Tenopora and in Coelenterata, we have not come across these words. ಈ ಮೂರು ಫೈಲಮ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡು ಬರದೇ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಗುಣಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳನ್ನ ನಾವು ಈ ಫೈಲಮ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬಯೋಲಾಟ್ರಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್, ಟ್ರಿಪ್ಲೋಬ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್, ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್. ಇದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು, ಸಿಫಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್. Cephalization is the other term which we see first time in this group. So then what are the meaning of these terms? So in Coryphora we have seen asymmetric organisms. The organisms were asymmetrical. Means so whenever the organism's body has cut into two cut by a plane, it is not giving the two equal parts. So the plate is not dividing the whole body into two equal parts. Andre body irregular agittu. So alli namge eradu samanada bhagalu doridirilla anta ondu bhagalannu hondiruvanta dehakke naavu enanta karididvi, asymmetrical anta karididvi. So Coryphorans alu asymmetrical group nalli bandidre naavu study madidanta innu eradu Cnidaria hagu Tenopora. ಈ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತು, ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ನೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್. ಹಂಗಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ದ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಶೇಪ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಟ್ ಬೈ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ವುಡ್ ಗಿವ್ ದಿ ಟೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಎರಡು ಸಮನಾದ ಭಾಗಗಳು ದೊರೀತಾ ಇದ್ವು. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇಂದ ಮಧ್ಯ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾದು ಹೋಗುವಂತೆ ನಾವು ಆ ಜೀವಿಯ ದೇಹವನ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎರಡು ಸಮನಾದ ಭಾಗಗಳು ದೊರೀತಾ ಇದ್ವು. ಅದು ಯಾವುದೇ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ನಾವು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಮಧ್ಯ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾದು ಹೋಗುವಂತೆ, ಮಧ್ಯ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾದು ಹೋಗುವಂತೆ ನಾವು ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಜೀವಿಯ ದೇಹ ಎರಡು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ದೊರೆತಿತ್ತು. ಅಂತ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತಿದ್ವಿ, ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 3 ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಶೋ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಹಾವ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ಸ್ನಿಡೇರಿಯಾ, ಟಿನೋಫೋರಾ, ಎಕೈನೋಡರ್ಮೇಟಾ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ 3 ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಶೋ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್. Porifera is the only group which shows symmetrical, and these are the 3 groups or the phyla which show the radial symmetrical, and remaining all the phyla from today onwards, whatever the phyla we are going to study after this class up to mammalia, they all are bilateral symmetrical. So why I am telling this one means you don't get confused whether the organism are all symmetrical, radial symmetrical or bilateral. So don't get such confusion. So take it very clearly in your mind. So Porifera is the only asymmetrical group, and Cnidaria, Ctenophora and Echinodermates are the only the radial symmetrical organisms, and remaining all the groups of organism starting from Platyhelminthes to the Mammalia all are bilaterally symmetrical. So this bilateral word we are observing in this group first time. Hence, what is bilateral? For example, I have drawn a diagram of organism which come under this group. The name of the organism is Planaria, which we also call it Dugesia. So if you cut this organism passing through its center, if you cut the organism in this plane, so we get the 2 equal parts. So hence this organism is called the bilateral symmetrical. So in the same manner, the organism, whichever organism come in this group, they give 2 equal parts. While a plane cut the organism passing through its center point. So they hence they are called bilaterally symmetrical. So next is triploblastin. In the groups of Cnidaria and Ctenophora, we have come across diploblastic animals, because these organism body has developed from 2 layers, ectoderm and endoderm. But in this group, the organism body has developed from 3 layers. Not only ectoderm and endoderm, there is one more layer is here, that is mesoderm. So 3 germ layers are involved in the formation of the organism's body. Hence these organisms are called triploblastic. So from this phylum onwards, all the organisms are triploblastic. So only these 2 are diploblastic, and remaining all are coming starting from Platyhelminthes to mammals, all are triploblastic animals. The next is organ level of organization. So here the cellular level of organization was there. In Cnidaria and Ctenophora we have seen the tissue level of organ system was there, but in case of Platyhelminthes, tissues were the tissues which were performing same functions, they together form organ. Means organs have developed in this group of organisms, and hence these are called the organ level. Not yet they have become organ system. There is no organ system, only organs are there. So cells, tissues, organs, when many organs together form a system, then this is called the organ system. Innu organ system anga yuhagala rachane agilla, bari angagala rachane agide. So idanna naavu gamdalli ittkobeku, angagala rachane agide. ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಅಂಗಗಳು ಕೂಡಿದಾಗ ಅಂಗಯುಹದ ರಚನೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂಗಯುಹ ಕಂಡು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇದಕ್ಕೇನಂತಾರ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಫಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಸಿಫಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಫಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್? ಸಿಫಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಡ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಸೀ ದ ಹೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಹೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಹೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ರಿಯಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್? ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಜವಾದ ಹೆಡ್ ಅನ್ಬೇಕು, ತಲೆ ಅನ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಜವಾದ ನಾವು ತಲೆ ಅಥವಾ ರಿಯಲ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ದ ಹೆಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಆ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಹೆಡ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಹೆಡ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಹೆಡ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಣ್ಣು, ಮೂಗು, ನಾಲ್ಗೆ, ಕಿವಿ ಈ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತಹ ಸೆನ್ಸರಿ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಗಳಿದಾವೆ. ಇದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ವೆಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಹೆಡ್. ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಇದೆ, ಇವುಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಹೊಂದಿರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಭಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತೀವಿ ತಲೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಹೆಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಈ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳ ತರ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಅವು, ಅವು ನಿಜವಾದ ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳಲ್ಲ, ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಏನು ನೋಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಹೊರಗಿನ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಸುತ್ತುವರೆದ ವಾತಾವರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳಕಿದೇನೋ ಇಲ್ಲವೋ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಗುರುತಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಗಳು, ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂತಾರ ಐ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ದೇ ರಿಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸೀ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಸನ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಗ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲಿಯಾನ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲಿಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ನರ್ವ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. The group of nerve cells together called the ganglion. So these ganglion gives rise to two pod-shaped nerve pods, and these nerve pods and ganglion together form the nervous system in this group. And such nervous system we call a lateralite. While discussing nervous system, we'll discuss that. So there is no nervous system. Don't think confused. The nerves or head region or nervous system or primitive nervous system is made by only ganglion and the nerve cords. We'll discuss that later. So the next part is. So these are the things which are coming first time in this group: bilateral, symmetrical, triploblastic, organ level of organization, and cephalization. These are the new terms which are coming in this group. And one more word is there, a coelomate. So coelomate means cavity. If the body cavity is called a coelom. But in this group, there is no body cavity. The organism is not having the body cavity. We have discussed what type of coeloms are there. Based on coelom, we are classifying the organisms into three groups. So while discussing basis of classification, we have come across about this word. But one more time, I will recall those things what we have studied in that class. So there are three groups of organism based on their body cavity: a coelom, pseudocoelom, and eucoelom. But now I am in this class, I am explaining only a coelom. So there are two layers. This outermost layer is called the body layer, is made by ectoderm, and inner layer or the alimentary canal covered layer is called the endoderm. So in between these two layers, there must be a mesoderm. But mesoderm is not lining. Mesoderm is there, but this cavity is filled with the tissues. This is a cavity, but this cavity is not empty. It's not a cavity. It's filled with the tissues or cells. So cells are completely filling this gap. So there is no empty cavity or place is available between the alimentary canal wall layer and the body wall layer. And such cavity is called the coelom. There is no cavity. Coelom means no cavity, no body cavity. And these cells are called the parenchyma cells. These are called the parenchyma cells. Don't get confused, because we are going to study parenchyma cells in plant tissues also. So there are different types of parenchyma cells. Here also we are calling these cells as a parenchyma cells, which are filling the gap between the body wall and the alimentary wall layer. So there is no cavity, hence they are called the coelomate. Clear? Next, we move to the next character of this organism. So, platyhelminthes are, most of them are endoparasites. Most of them are endoparasites. Some of them are free living. The next character. Most of the platyhelminthes are endoparasites, but some are free living. Don't think all organisms coming in this group are parasites only. Most of them are endoparasites, but some are there in this group which are free living. So parasite word we already come across. Parasites means paravalambigalu. ಯಾವ ತಮ್ಮ ಆಹಾರವನ್ನು ತಾವೇ ತಯಾರಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳದೆ ತಮ್ಮ ಆಹಾರಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಬೇರೆ ಜೀವಿಗಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಅವಲಂಬನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಪರಾವಲಂಬಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಹೌದಾ? So parasites means those which gets their food from another organisms. But endoparasite means parasites na eradu iti parasites ada. One ectoparasite, innondu endoparasite. Ecto andre horegade. Ahara padidava adre ಅವು ಜೀವಿಯ ದೇಹದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಇದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಹಾರ ಪಡಿತಿದ್ರೆ ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಎಕ್ಟೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಫುಡ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ನಮಗೆ ಆಹಾರವನ್ನು ಕೊಡುವಂತ ಜೀವಿಯ ದೇಹದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಇದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಹಾರ ಪಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಂತವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂತಾರ? ಎಕ್ಟೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ಅಂತಾರ. ಬಟ್ ಇವು ಎಂಡೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್. ಎಂಡೋ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್, ಎಂಡೋ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್, ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪರಾವಲಂಬಿಗಳು. They get their food being inside the host organism's body. They lead their parasitic life being inside the host organism's body. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತಮಗೆ ಆಶ್ರಯ ಕೊಟ್ಟಂತ ಜೀವಿಯ ದೇಹದ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಹಾರನ ಪಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಂತವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂತಾರ? ಎಂಡೋ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರ. ಸೊ ಈ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಗಳು ಬರ್ತಾವ, ಕರ್ಬಲೇರಿಯಾ, ಟ್ರಿಮೇಟೋಡಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟೋ. ಸೊ ಟರ್ಬಲೇರಿಯಾ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಫ್ರೀ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಮಲೇರಿಯಾ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನು ಟ್ರಿಮೇಟೋಡಾ ಮತ್ತು ಸಿಸ್ಟೋಡಾ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್. ವಿ ವುಡ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಎಂಡೋ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಟ್ಯಾನಿಯಾ ಸೋಲಿಯಂ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಟೇಪೋಮ್, ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್. Liver fluke is a common name. Scientifically, it is called the Tasiola hepatica. Tasiola hepatica. It's a scientific name. Its common name is liver fluke. These are most common. So, endoparasites. These are the endoparasites. So, we may give the example for free living also. Planaria. Planaria, or which may also call it Dugasia, is one of the free living organism. So it's a free living, it's not depending on any organism's body. It means it is not living in organism, it searches its food and gets its food. And such organisms are called free living. So for the endoparasitic lifestyle, they need certain adaptations because they have to live in the other organism's body. So they need certain adaptation to survive inside the other organism body. And those adaptations are, they have hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers are the best adaptations to those organisms which are living in another organism body. For example, endoparasites bears the hooks and suckers. And these hooks and suckers are useful to them to attach on their body wall. So, intestinal wall. For example, I am going to draw the diagram of the head region of tapeworm. It's a small pin-like head. These are hooks. And there are four suckers, two on front side, two on back side. These are suckers. And by using these things, they attach on the intestinal wall. This is the intestinal wall. So they use these things to attach themselves on the intestinal wall. Aa jeeviya dehada olagade sanna karulina olagade adara sanna karulina godege antukollike ee ondu structures anna upayogisukotavu. ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡು ಬರ್ತಾವ? ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬದುಕಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಗೋಡೆಗೆ, ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಗೋಡೆಗೆ ಅಂಟುಕೊಂಡು ಬದುಕಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇವೆರಡು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ? ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ. ಇಲ್ಲ, ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್. ಡೈಜೆಷನ್, ಜೀರ್ಣಕ್ರಿಯೆ. The endoparasites do not have any digestive organs. ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಜೀರ್ಣಾಂಗಗಳು ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಡು ಬರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಜೀರ್ಣಿಸಲ್ಪಟ್ಟ ಆಹಾರ ದೊರಕ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಬೈ ದೇರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ದೇ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ದಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಹೋಸ್ಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಥ್ರೂ ದೇರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ತಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಜೀರ್ಣಿಸಲ್ಪಟ್ಟಂತ ಆಹಾರವನ್ನು ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸಲು ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಜೀರ್ಣಾಂಗಗಳನ್ನ ಹೊಂದುವ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಎಂಡೋಪ್ಯಾರಾಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ digestive organs, or you may call the digestive system is completely absent, or alimentary canal is completely absent in endoparasites. But what about the free living? So here I have drawn the free living alimentary canal structure very in simple form. This is the opening which we call the mouth. So these are carnivorous, means they feed on other small organisms. So they get their food through this mouth, and that food is digested in this alimentary canal, and the waste material is also eliminated through this opening only. Means they have only one opening to their alimentary canal. The food is taken from that opening only, and the waste is also removed from that opening only. And such alimentary canal, either you may call the incomplete alimentary canal, or we may also call this one as a blind sac body plant. This is called the blind sac body plant. Means the alimentary canal has only one opening, there is no axe. Either you may call it as incomplete digestive system, incomplete alimentary canal, or we may call blind sac body plant. Such structure we see in the free living organisms like planaria. So next we'll discuss about their next character. So the next week we'll talk about the excretion, how they excrete. Because circulatory and respiratory organs are completely absent, so we'll move to the next physiological activity in their body, that is excretion or excretory system. So the free living organisms like planaria are amnotelic. They excrete ammonia as their nitrogenous waste. So these wastes are excreted out of their body with the help of specialized cells, and these specialized cells are called the flame cells or solenocytes. They are also called the solenocytes. Flame cells means generally flame andre uri naalige anta karidivi. The structure itself is like that flame. The shape or the structure of these flame cells are like this. This is the cavity and nucleus, cytoplasm. Here are some basal ganglia and cilia are there. And there is a tube-like structure, and nitrogenous waste is absorbed and it is removed through this tubular structure. This is the structure of a flame cell. While absorbing the nitrogenous waste, so by the action of cilia, these cells are moving. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಬೆಂಕಿಯ ನಾಲ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಅಳಗಾಡುತ್ತೋ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತವ, ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನಂತ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ರೆ ಫ್ಲೇಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. So excretion takes place by the help of a special kinds of cells, and these cells are called the flame cells. Next, reproduction in plantain elements. So in this group there are some organisms, for example if you take planaria only, they show a asexual type of reproduction that is also very specific type, that is power of regeneration. They have very high power of regeneration. For example, planarium. In planarium, we see a special kind of reproduction, that is power of regeneration. So then what is the meaning of power of regeneration? Means if the planaria is cut into many pieces, if you cut into 2 or 3 or 5 pieces, a single planaria is cut into many pieces, each piece or the body part will develop into a new planaria. Suppose this is the planaria. If you cut this planaria into 3 parts, this is one part, second, third part. Each part will develop into a new individual. This is one part will develop like this. Another part, second part is also going to develop a new planaria. And this third part is also going to develop into a new planaria. Means whatever number of the pieces are there, they all are going to develop into a new individual. And this capacity is of generation is called the power of regeneration, which is there in the planet. This is one type of reproduction. Next, we'll talk about the sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. So, these are hermaphrodites, means in this group also, sexes are not separated. Sexes are not separated. Or you may call the hermaphrodite. Or we may also refer one more word, bisexual. But the fertilization is internal. Fertilization is internal. Hermaphrodites or sexes are not separate means the same individual possesses both male and female sex organ. The same individual produces both male and female gametes. And these gamete fusion takes place inside the organism body. Hence the fertilization is called the internal. But here, one more thing we have to understand. So, the fertilization may be cross-fertilization or self-fertilization. Because in the PUC 2 class, where we are also discussing the planaria, reproduction in planaria, we are also studying in PUC 2nd year class also. So, better we understand here itself only. In planaria, if you talk about the planaria, here also the fertilization is internal, but the fertilization is cross-fertilization. In planaria, fertilization is cross-fertilization and fertilization takes place inside the organism body. But in case of tapeworm, here also the fertilization is internal. But it is self-fertilization. Here the fertilization is self-fertilization. But in case of planaria, the fertilization is cross-fertilization. So then what is the meaning of these two? So cross-fertilization means the one here two organisms should involve. Two planaria should be there in this process. Both are producing male and female gametes. Both have the capacity to produce male and female gametes. So, this planaria also able to produce male and female gametes. This planaria also able to produce male and female gametes. Because here sexes are not separated. They are hermaphrodites or bisexual. They are able to produce both kinds of gametes, but their own gametes are not fusing here. So, the male gamete of this organism will fuse to the female gamete of this. Means, they are donating or letting their sperms to meet the egg of another organism or another planet. And this type of fertilization we call as a cross fertilization. So fertilization is internal, but it is cross fertilization in the planaria. Even though these are hermaphrodites, the fertilization is cross fertilization. But in case of tapeworm, these are also hermaphrodites. Here also sexes are not separated. The same individual produces two types of gametes, and these two gametes are fused together. The gamete produced from the tapeworm, the single organism produces the two gametes, and these gametes fuse together and form the zygote. And here both the gametes are belonging to the same individual, but here one gamete is belonging to one organism, another gamete is belonging to the another organism. And such fusion is called the cross fertilization, and this fusion is called the self fertilization. So even though tapeworm is hermaphrodite, it shows the self fertilization, but planaria being this also hermaphrodite, it shows the cross fertilization. And their development is indirected with many larval stage. Development is indirect with many larval stage. Larval stage. The life cycle not only has a single larva, because the life cycle itself continues in endoparasites with two hosts. If you take the tapeworm, the sexual reproduction takes place in human being, and the eggs are forming, the fusion, the zygotes are forming, which are in the form of eggs, fertilized eggs. The fertilized eggs are removed by the man through his fecal matter. And inside the fecal matter, the eggs are hatching and they are in the form of larva. When the eggs are hatching, they are in the larval stage, and that larval stage of this form is called the hexokantha. This is one larval stage. When this fecal matter along with larva is eaten by the pig. So here also it produces asexually. Asexual reproduction takes place in the fig, and the fig meat process the larva. Fig meat process the larva, and these larva are called the cysticercus. Cysticercus. This is another larval stage. So in the life cycle of this tapeworm, there are two larval stage. One larva is coming from the sexual reproduction taking place in the human being, and that larval stage is called hexokantha, and another larval stage is producing in the pig body, and that is called the cysticercus. So means the development is indirect, and they not only have the single larval stage, they may have many larval stage. For example, here we see the two larval stage to complete the life cycle of the tapeworm. So we are going to conclude the excretion process. One more thing we have left, that is nervous system. Nervous system. So nervous system is not so well developed. As I told you, it's a ladder shape. Ladder shape, because in this region, ventral side, on the ventral side, it's a dorsal surface. On the ventral surface of their body, there are a group of nerve cells, and they together form the ganglion. And this is the body. And these ganglion produce their axon. They give rise to their axon, which are rod shaped, which are parallel to each other. They are solid and rod shaped. Solid or rod shaped. And they are interconnected, because here are some ganglion are there, and their axon connect one another. So they are interconnected. So it looks like a ladder. Hence, the nervous system in plantain helminth, this is called the ladder shape. So this nervous system is ventral, solid, it's very simple type of nervous system. But in higher animals, we see the dorsal hollow nerve. Here is a solid nerve cord. So examples which are coming, or the organs which come in this group, are already have mentioned. One is planaria, tapeworm, liver fluke. So these are the some of the examples of this group.